But first, our top story tonight. If a five-week campaign wasn't long enough, Labor will now spend another 5 weeks again deciding who will lead it in opposition. Anthony Albanese today joined Bill Shorten in the contest, and under the party's new rules devised by Kevin Rudd, the entire Labor membership, as well as the parliamentary party, get a vote. But will that system work? Here's Leah Craven.
One from the left, the other from Labor's right. Both say their best place to lead and rebuild their party. Anthony Albanese only formally declaring today.
I believe I'm the best candidate, otherwise I wouldn't have run.
I'm pleased with the support I've received so far from my caucus colleagues.
The process to pick a leader will take weeks. Votes by the Parliamentary Labor Party and the rank and file members will be given equal weight.
We have over the next 30 days new politics.
It will be a US primary style contest, but with civility, they say.
What you won't see from me at any stage is any criticism or any critique of Bill Shorten's candidature.
Labor is drawing a line underneath the rancour of previous years.
Kevin Rudd won't lead the party in the meantime. Former Treasurer Chris Bowen will hold the fort until the ballot is decided.
The new Labor leader will have more legitimacy than any other political leader in Australian history. They will have been elected by their whole Labor Party.
This leader's savouring the moment.
My friends, it is my honour to welcome you back to Canberra as the Prime Minister-elect of Australia.
But not everyone remembered there'd been a change of guard. Former Labor Minister Kate Lundy accidentally wandered into the new government's party room.
You lost the election, Kate.
Tony Abbott will keep his front bench largely unchanged when it's unveiled over the weekend. Nationals leader Warren Truss was re-elected unopposed, but has an ambitious new deputy. Barnaby Joyce has never hidden his desire to lead the Nationals.
Leah Craven reporting there. Now for some analysis on this, we go to Canberra and our National Affairs editor, Paul Bongiorno. Now, Bonge, what's your take on the leadership skills of Bill Shorten versus those of Anthony Albanese?
Well, they have their own gifts, as they say. Anthony Albanese has the great advantage of being a 17-year veteran of the Parliament. He's had senior positions in both opposition and in government. He knows the Parliament inside out, and he has a sense of humour as well as that hint of the mongrel, the attack dog in him, which many in Labor are looking for. Bill Shorten has a very good reputation. He's a competent administrator. He's transactional. He was the one that gave us the NDIS. He had a meteoric rise in the union movement and gained a lot of kudos for the way in which he led the giant Australian Workers' Union.
Bonge, 3 years is a long time, particularly in politics. Is whoever is chosen as leader likely to still be the leader by the time the next election rolls round?
Ah, well, what we have here, Danny, is the Kevin Rudd rules, and it's almost impossible once you elect a Labor leader between elections or straight after an election to get rid of them. I think in opposition you need 60% of the caucus to say we want to get rid of him or her, in government 75%, and they say that's a very high benchmark.
And when we're all talking about Labor, how does it play for the new government? The focus is off them a bit.
Well, it is off them, and probably on purpose, because Tony Abbott is being meticulous, and transition to government, no small thing, and he's been having meetings. He's been meeting key people in the bureaucracy, and he should be ready to name his ministry on the weekend and be sworn in either Tuesday or Wednesday. I'm sure that he doesn't mind that Labor's filling the vacuum with all the question marks over who'll lead it, and is it looking messy or is it looking democratic?
Paul Bongiorno, thanks for joining us.